Today, I will explain you how the SAEM algorithm works step by step. The SAEM algorithm is used for the estimation of the population parameters, this task here. The goal is to find the population parameters that maximize the likelihood, which is our objective function. When I run the task, I can follow how the population parameters evolve over the iteration of the algorithm. SAEM works in two phases. During the first one, called exploratory, the goal is to explore the parameter space a lot and get to a neighborhood of the maximum likelihood. During the second phase, called the smoothing, after the red line, we really converge to the maximum likelihood. I will now explain you how we go from one iteration to the next one, step by step. For this, I have chosen a very simple one-compartment model with parameters V and K, so a bolus administration and a linear elimination. And to better follow what is going on, I have fixed all population parameters except VPOP and KPOP, which have starting values 10 and 0.1. In the plot we see here, I have the value of KPOP on the x-axis, VPOP on the y-axis. The black dot is my starting point, the initial values, and the color map represents the values of the likelihood. The SAEM algorithm does not know about those likelihood values. I have just set them as background, such as we know where the maximum likelihood is. SAEM starts with the exploratory phase. The first step is to generate individual parameters psi from the conditional distribution. The conditional distribution is the probability distribution of psi given the data y and the population parameters at the previous iteration theta k. This distribution has no analytical expression. To sample values from this distribution, we use a Markov chain Monte Carlo procedure and we generate one value per individual. If I have 10 individuals in my dataset, it would be those 10 stars here, for instance. As you can see, the conditional distribution takes into account the population parameters at the previous iteration, so in my case, the starting point, but also the data. And this will help to pull the individual parameters closer to the maximum likelihood compared to the population parameters. In a second step, I calculate the new population parameters at iteration k plus 1 by simply averaging over the sampled individual parameters. This leads to the black dot here, so the value of kpop and vpop at iteration k plus 1. This formula is valid for the fixed effects in this simple case. For the omegas, or in case of covariates, inter-occasion variability, or mixture models, it's a bit more complicated. Then I start again for the next iteration. I generate new individual parameters, and I average them to get the population parameters for the next iteration, etc., etc. So that's how I get from one iteration to the next one. I will now show you the full trajectory of the exploratory phase. During this phase, we converge to a neighborhood of the maximum likelihood and we then perform a random walk in this region. This is because at each iteration, the average over the individual parameters is a bit different. So at the end of the exploratory phase, I'm constantly moving around the maximum likelihood. So that's a great first step to get close, but we now need to really find the precise maximum likelihood. For that, we have the second smoothing phase. I have highlighted the starting point for the smoothing phase. It's just the last point of the exploratory phase. And I will hide the exploratory phase to see a bit better what is going on. The first step is the same as before. I generate individual parameters using Markov chain Monte Carlo. In the second step, however, instead of averaging the values of only the last iteration, I average the values of all previous iterations of the smoothing phase. For the first smoothing iteration, it's only those 10 points. Then for the next iteration, I generate 10 more points using the population parameters of iteration 1 and now average over those 20 individual parameter values to get the population parameters of iteration 2. For iteration 3, I generate again 10 more individual parameters and now average over 30 values to get the new population parameters, etc., etc. This requires memorizing all individual parameters, but in fact we can see that this part here of the formula is exactly what I would have used to calculate theta k, so the theta at the previous iteration. So I can rewrite it in this way, which is simpler to handle computationally. And in addition, one usually rewrites the formula like that, because that's the typical way to write the stochastic approximation formula. Now let's visualize the entire smoothing phase. We can really see how accumulating more and more individual parameters permit to smoothly reach the maximum likelihood. This was a small example. As I have said, for more complex models, the procedure is a bit more complicated, but the concepts remain the same. The SAEM algorithm has been proven formally to converge almost surely to the maximum likelihood estimate, and it has been shown to work in practice for a large variety of datasets and models. In opposition to FOCE, for instance, it is a stochastic algorithm due to the sampling of the individual parameters. It means that the trajectory in the parameter space will depend on the seed of the random number generator. In monoliths, the seed is fixed to ensure reproducibility of the results, and you can check the influence of the seed by using the convergence assessment. And finally, notice that in the procedure I have described, I have never calculated the likelihood. SAEM permits to optimize the objective function, the likelihood, without calculating it explicitly. To know the value of the likelihood, a separate estimation task is required. That's it for today. Have a nice week.